Barclays.com live here with Paulie Malignaggi. Obviously, Paulie, you've been at the Barclays Center so many times. Lucky for you, all your fights have kind of had some sort of nostalgia attached to them. Yeah. One time you were in there with Zab Judah, which made it memorable not only for you, but for Brooklyn. Now this time around it's with Tito Becerra, another New York guy, someone you know from the amateur, someone you know all your career, and he's coming off a big knockout, his last win. Yeah. What does this mean to you to close out your career at the Barclays?
It means a lot, you know, and Tito's a quality fighter, he's a quality operator, he's a guy that I've known for a long time, he's a friend of mine, I feel. And, you know, I know he's going to bring the best, and he's a hungry fighter. So I feel like I got no slouch in front of me. I got a fighter who's coming to try to make a better life for himself, a better career for himself. A fighter who feels he's lost a lot of time, so he needs to make up for it. And he sees me as the guy in his way. So friends or no friends, you know, there's going to be a very competitive atmosphere inside the ring on that night between me and Gabe Becerra.
Right now, the welterweight division is a bit of a hotbed between this one and 154. Now, I know you want to close out the career, but a big win over Becerra could put you back in the runnings of another title shot. Is that something you're looking at?
It could, but I'm looking at the European Championship. I want to become the European Champion before I retire. If I could, and that's the thing with me. You know, people say, oh, Becerra has more to gain from this fight, you know, because Paulie's kind of won his championships and where does he go? But in reality, I want to win the European Championship. And if I get beat, I lose my spot even in the European ratings, you know. Right now, I'm the mandatory for the European title. So I want to win this fight and win it impressively, keep my mandatory status and be able to challenge for the European title later in the year. And then hopefully call it a career, but we'll see.
Speaking of the Europeans, the UK has always treated you well. You've done Sky Sports. Chris Eubank is attempting to challenge Gennady Golovkin. What do you think of his shots? Is the pedigree of his father enough?
You know, he's got balls, and I love the command he has about himself. You know, you don't see anybody chasing Golovkin. You know, no middleweights anyway. This guy wants Golovkin. He's chasing him. So no matter what the result is in the end, I think he's gonna go out fighting, and he's gonna go in fighting hard. And I feel like he'll be able to tag Golovkin a little bit too. You know, I don't know that he can win the fight, but he would pleasantly surprise me if he won it. I think boxing always loves upsets. Golovkin right now seems too good, but he is a guy that can. I think presents a little bit of problems to Golovkin.
Last question, obviously you're looking very in shape and you got a great tan, so are you holding camp here in New York or somewhere else?
I was in Miami and New York. I'm actually going back to Miami next week. You know,
Miami, were you with John David Jackson?
No, South Beach. Fifth Street Gym.
And head trainer?
I've been working with Luis. Okay. It's Cheto.
All right, well thank you very much, Paulie. Enjoy the day.
All right, take care, guys.